so much for watching this video. I feel a little bit silly posting today's video, but I've had so many people ask me about my makeup routine and what makeup I use, and so I figured I might as well share. But what I'm sharing with you today is my 10-minute professional face, what I wear to work every single day to try to look professional but also not spend a ton of time doing makeup. I do my makeup at the gym every day. I've actually been getting ready at the gym every morning, 5 days a week, about for the past 3 months or so, and it's been going really well. So this is my super easy routine that fits in my little makeup bag, and I do it every day, so I'm going to show it with you today, and I hope you like it. All right, so starting with my everyday 10-minute professional makeup look. I feel like I want my face to look very nice and put together, but I don't want to look overdone for work. And studies have actually shown that wearing a small amount of makeup makes you come across as more professional, more put together. And I know that that's a terrible double standard that we as women have to live up to, but it's the reality. And I actually really enjoy doing makeup, and so I don't mind it too much. But this is my quick routine. Doesn't take too long, but also I feel like gives me a very nice polished face, stays in place all day, even in the operating room. And so this is what I go for every day. I'm not going to go through the skincare that I do beforehand, but generally I shower at the gym. I don't always wash my hair, and so I'll just put a serum and then a moisturizer on my face. And then after I do that, the very next thing I use is this product from Too Faced. This is the Prime Set Refresh Hangover 3-in-1 Replenishing Primer and Setting Spray with coconut water, probiotic-based ingredient, and skin revivers, silicone-free, alcohol-free, oil-free. It's actually great. It smells so nice. It has the nicest, fresh kind of coconut water type scent. It's really refreshing on your face, and I use it as a primer and as a makeup setter. This is the first time that I've used this, but I would purchase it again. I really enjoy using this. So after I put on my moisturizer, then the next thing I do is just spray this all over my face to use as a primer. I've used primers before, like the Benefit Pore Professional Primer, and I don't feel like it makes my pores look any smaller than this does. And this is way easy because it's just a mist, so I just spray it everywhere and then it's over. Okay. So then the next thing I do after my face is kind of dry and that's all set is my foundation. And I am a huge fan of the Estee Lauder Double Wear Foundation. I've been wearing it. I've repurchased it twice now. I've tried several other foundations, but this is the one that I found gives me the best coverage and stays all day. It does come off on my surgical mask a little bit, but not bad. And it doesn't even look bad if it's on my surgical mask. It doesn't give me like a line or anything. So I really enjoy the Estee Lauder Double Wear. I wear the color Dawn, and so this is the Double Wear, but this is the color Dawn, and so I have the big bottle here, but then also most of the time when you buy a big bottle, they give you a little travel size in your color as well. And so what I have been doing is I've been just using the travel size in my makeup bag because I carry it with me to work and the gym, and it's way easier than to carry this big one. So I just refill the little one with the big one as needed, and I only use the little one every day. So what I'll do is I will just kind of shake a little bit of this out into my finger. My only complaint with the Double Wear is that it doesn't come with a pump, which I would much prefer a pump. It's more sanitary, I think. So if any of you know of a good pump that will fit onto the big Double Wear, that would be great. Just let me know in the comments. I would really appreciate it. But I generally just kind of dab a little bit out into my finger, and then I dab it on my face. And then I will either use a beauty blender to blend it in, or I will use a face brush. This is a foundation brush from Morphe. I actually got this brush in a set of other Morphe brushes. It's a face set. And I'll put all of this in the description box below so that you guys will know everything. But this is a synthetic brush. It's vegan, which I really appreciate. And so I really enjoy using this brush to spread out my foundation. I feel like it works really well, and it's way faster than the beauty blender. So that's one good thing about this brush. After I've done my foundation, the next thing I do is concealer, and right now I'm using the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer. This seems to be a cult classic. Everybody loves this concealer. It's really, really nice. I agree. And I am using the color Cannelle. I've also tried the Maybelline Age Rewind Concealer, which I've heard is a really good kind of dupe for this. But honestly, I think the NARS is way better. I put it under my eye and then down in a line by my nose and down a line here so that it fills in like a little triangular area underneath my eye. And then I generally do use a beauty blender to kind of blend it in just under my eye. And I feel like it really does kind of brighten up your whole face and make you look really nice. So I really enjoy this NARS product. The next thing I use is a powder to just kind of set the foundation and my concealer. And I have been using the MAC Studio Fix powder forever. I started using this in high school and I always use the same shade. I use NW25, that is my shade. And I love the Studio Fix. This is probably the 20th one of these I've bought. And it's just a really nice powder. It gives you a great coverage, but it doesn't make you look too cakey, I don't think. I really enjoy using this. And so I will use a big fluffy brush to just kind of set my concealer under my eyes and then just rub my powder kind of all over my face to just set everything. And that's just what I like to do. I don't think you need a powder over a foundation, but that's what I do. Next, I like to bring some color to my face, and I actually, so you'll find that my whole kind of makeup set is all face and then hardly anything else. And I just think it's really nice to have a clean, fresh canvas and have your skin look good and your face look good. I think it makes you look very professional and put together. And so I tend to focus mostly on face stuff. So the next thing I use is a bronzer, and I do a little kind of contour with my bronzer, and I use the NARS Laguna bronzer is what I'm using right now. I've used this before. I've also used a Makeup Forever bronzer that I really liked, and I've used a Bare Minerals bronzer that was okay, but the Laguna bronzer is a sure thing, always good, will never let you down. It's a beautiful bronzer. It's pretty matte, but it has like a tiny bit of a glow, but honestly, it's pretty matte, and so I will use this angled kind of a contouring brush. Again, this is from the Morphe set, and I'll just kind of put it in a contoury way on my cheeks, both sides, and then I do it a little under my chin and sometimes on my forehead. And then the next thing I'll do is I'll use a brush from my next product. So this is the Chanel Le Beige, and this is the most beautiful powder. It comes in a really beautiful compact and it has the Chanel brush. So the first thing I do before I actually use this product is I use this Chanel brush, which is like perfect for just putting a little bronzer on each side of my nose. And so I go back to the Laguna bronzer and I just dab a little bit with the Chanel brush, and then I do use that to just put a little bit of kind of contour just on the sides of my nose, not in the middle. And that might be super high maintenance to kind of contour my nose like that, but I just feel like it makes my face look nice. So then I actually do use the Chanel Le Beige, and I honestly just give myself a little brush on each cheek. This smells so nice. I love this smell. It's highly perfumed, but it's a beautiful smell. And I feel like this gives you such a nice kind of golden glow on top of the NARS, which the Laguna is a little bit more kind of harsh and dark. And this, to me, I feel like isn't quite enough to contour, but it gives you the most beautiful bronze, and I love it so much. So this is the medium light of the Le Beige powder. And I've also heard really good things about the creamy bronzer from Chanel, but I'm all about the Le Beige medium light. It's lovely. Okay, so then the next thing I do is blush, and back to the NARS. I am a diehard fan of the NARS Orgasm Blush. It's the absolute most beautiful blush color I've ever seen, and I'd love your suggestions for other blush colors, but honestly, I just can't not do this one. It's so good. I've used it over and over and over, and it's my absolute fave. So I don't want to use too many brushes, so I just use the same contour brush that I did for the bronzer, and I just do a tiny, tiny bit, and just kind of rosy up both of my cheeks. And then, actually, let me backtrack for a second. The other thing I do with the Chanel Le Beige is I put it on my eyelids, just in the crease. It takes 2 seconds to do that on both eyes, and that I feel like adds a kind of warmth to my eyelids without having to do eyeshadow. Then back to the blush. I will actually, after I put it on my cheeks, I end up just putting it on my eyelids as well, just like a tiny little blush brush to brighten up my eyelids, because I generally don't do eyeshadow. I find that lots of eyeshadow, at least to me, looks a little overdone for the daytime, and I just don't feel like it always comes across as professional unless you're really, really good at eyeshadow, which I'm clearly not. And so it's easier for me to just focus on the face and then use a little bit of the face products to just give my eyes a little bit of definition, but nothing too serious. So then the last face product I use is a highlight, and I actually keep intending to purchase a highlighter, and so if you guys have any recommendations for a good highlight, then let me know. But this is a Smashbox set that I actually received through Influencer, which sends like free products to people. Anybody can sign up for it, and then you just get free stuff, and then you have to rate it online. So I got this Smashbox set. It's the CoverShot Soft Light Eye Palette. And it's actually really beautiful. So it comes with these really, really beautiful eyeshadow colors, which I honestly have barely touched because I don't really do a ton of eyeshadow. But there's two highlights that come up here. One is more of a golden and one has more of like a blue pinky undertone. And I honestly love them both. I tend to use the golden a little bit more because it's a little bit softer, I think, for the daytime, but they're both super. And so what I'll do is I'll just rub my finger in the golden one, and then I'll just kind of put it on the apple of my cheek just to give myself a little highlight. And then sometimes I'll even run it down right the bridge of my nose and blend it in just a little. And sometimes even right there on my Cupid's bow or whatever they call that. After I'm done with all of my face products, so that's foundation, concealer, powder, bronzer, another bronzer, blush, and highlight. That seems like a lot, but I swear it does not take me very much time at all. It's just like zoop, zoop, zoop. After I'm done with all of those, I like to put setting spray on my face at that point because I find that if I wait until after I've done my mascara and I put setting spray, then it'll cause my mascara to fall and I'll get black specks on my eyes. I don't know if that's just my problem, but that happens to me all the time. So at this point, I will do my setting spray. And so I will go back to the Too Faced Hangover 3-in-1 Sweat Setting Spray or Primer Setting Spray, and I'll give myself a nice spray again. This stuff is so nice. It smells so good. Like coconut. And so I will do that and then let it dry. And then I feel like my skin is pretty dry, and so I'm all about adding moisture. And so I also love using this. This is the Caudalie Beauty Elixir. I'm obsessed with this. This is my second bottle of this, and I love it so much. Caudalie is an amazing company. This product doesn't have any parabens. It doesn't have any animal testing. It's completely natural fragrance. It's basically just natural oils, and it's lovely. And they say that you can use it before makeup or at any time of the day to refresh your skin or set your makeup. So I use it as a setter, again, on top of the Too Faced, because I feel like it just adds a little extra moisture. And it's so nice. It's so nice. It feels like you're at the spa. It's totally worth it. It's kind of pricey, and it's just wonderful. Okay, the next step in my routine is to do my brows, and I don't have a great brow routine. I really need to step up my brow game, but honestly, I just use a drugstore brow pencil that has a little brow brush, and I kind of just brush my brows up a little, and then I use this pencil to just kind of fill in, honestly, I just fill them in a little bit just to give them a little bit more definition, and that's all I do. So if you have any suggestions about stepping up my brow game, I would be all for it. I actually do this brow step along with all of my other face stuff before I do the setting spray, so I forgot this happens before the setting spray. Okay, good. All right, once all the setting spray is dry and my face is done, then my last Few steps are, first I apply some eyeliner to my bottom kind of waterline. I either use, this is just a plain black liner from Sephora. It's a Sephora brand. I think I got it in this as a sample. It's just called Kohl, and it's really nice. I actually feel like it doesn't have any fallout. I feel like it stays on my lid. It's a really nice, like, smooth. I was gonna swatch it out for you, but I don't know if you can see it. It's just a really nice smooth black pencil, and I don't mind using a little bit of black just to give my eyes a little bit more definition. And I generally just do it on the bottom. I don't always do it on the top, although sometimes I will do it on the top and then not the bottom. So I just do one or the other. I don't line both lids because I feel like that's a little harsh for the workday, but I'll do one or the other. And if I don't use the black, then I have this brown from Urban Decay that I love. It's a really beautiful brown. It's the color is bourbon, and I think browns look really nice with blondes, so I do like using this one a lot, except it's a little soft, and so I just have to be careful. Otherwise, I feel like you can just get it everywhere. So that's that. And then the next step is mascara. And I mentioned in another one of my videos that my biggest mascara trick is to just use the sample size mascaras. And so I honestly feel like if you get a full size mascara, you can't use it all before it gets dried out or contaminated with all the bacteria from your eyelids or just gross, and you shouldn't be using mascara more than a month or two anyways. And so I find that it is the most effective to just get the small sample sizes. And the way that I do that is that every year around the holidays, Sephora will have a big sampler set with maybe like 12 different sample mascaras, and then you have one a month for the whole year, and then you're done with mascara for the whole year. So I'm always trying different ones. The most recent one that I've been trying is the Dior Show mascara. And honestly, I'd never tried a Dior mascara before, and I know that they're like very hyped about, and now I understand the hype. This is the best mascara ever. I love it. I actually just recently switched to a new one from the Dior. I switched to the Kevin Aucoin, which is also in my sampler set, and I don't like it near as much as the Dior one. So I do love this, and I do put on a lot of mascara, top and bottom, and that's that. And then my very last step is just a little bit of lip gloss. This is a Burt's Bees gloss that I've been really liking lately. And so I just do a little bit of lip gloss to give my lips some color. And then I am done. And so this whole kind of spread takes me about 10 minutes, stays on my face all day. I feel like looks fairly professional and is my go-to makeup. So I hope you enjoyed, and I would love to know what you use or tips for makeup. I definitely am not an expert. So thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Talk to y'all later. Bye.